What's up, Xbox Series S fam? One of the questions most of you have been asking me is how many games can you actually fit on the Xbox Series S hard drive? Well, you can see I've got quite a lot here, but I do have an external hard drive plugged in. And if you want to see how to get a cheap external SSD to play a lot of your Game Pass games and games which are not optimized for Series S, check out the card in the top right hand corner of the screen to see that video. But I have maxed out my internal hard drive on the Xbox Series S. If we go over to storage devices, you can see I've only got 1.3 gigabytes free of the 364 gigabytes which is available. So that's 99.6% is used. I couldn't get it any higher. I tried to completely max it out, but this was the best I could do. And you can see my external hard drive has got a little bit free, 70 gigabytes free there. But the question is, how many games can you store on your SSD on your Xbox Series S? Well, with the storage here, let's check out. Boom, so I've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 games. And I tried to make this realistic and have a good mixture of games which you'll all probably play, along with some smaller kind of indie titles. So we've got Apex Legends, Bright Memory, Black Ops Cold War, we've got Call of Duty Warzone, we've got Fortnite, The Witcher 3, The Tourist, No Man's Sky, Minecraft Dungeons, and Minecraft. So this should give you an idea of what kind of games you could get on this. A lot of you have been asking me saying, Murray, can I get Cold War and Warzone on there and like FIFA or something? The answer is yes, easily. So you can see here we've got like The Witcher, pretty big game there. That's a decent amount of size. I don't know if I can actually see the size of the game. I think it's about 40 gigabytes nearly. And then we've also got the three big battle royale games, Apex Legends, Warzone, and Fortnite, and then other full games like No Man's Sky and Minecraft Dungeons, alongside smaller games like Bright Memory, Minecraft, and The Tourist. So let me know what you think about that down below. Any questions you have on Xbox Series S, please let me know. If you found this useful, please smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. And remember to ask me any other questions about Xbox Series S you have, and I will try and answer them for you. So thank you very much for watching. Much love to all your faces. We'll see you on the next video, my friends.